Medical doctors of Reddit, what drug from your specialty would you never take as a patient, and why not? Pharmacist, so I have a few. Carlistin for antibiotics, lithium, topiramate, most antipsychotics, metformin, just BCI don't want to be diabetic, and Accutane are my big ones. Honorable mentions for ones I hope I never need would be opiates, benzos, threes, anticoagulants, and chemo drugs. I really just don't like taking medicine in general. General physician here. Benzodiazepines, on the basis that they simply aren't safe, especially for long-term use. Since tolerance and dependence occur after just a few weeks of using these, you end up with more adverse than desired effects after only a short while, and with a very rough time weaning yourself off these drugs again. Yes, there are a number of indications where the benefits outweigh the adverse effects, but it's a very limited list. And yet, benzo use remains a sort of epidemic in Belgium, with approximately 1 in 10 people using them. In my experience, benzo use is much too normalized in our culture. People don't even seem to think twice about their little sleeping pill. I won't take any drug in the quinolone family, Cipro, Levaquin, etc. The side effects are commonly minimized by the medical community, or ignored, but can be so bad from a neuropsychiatric standpoint, that for some people it can take months to recover from. There are very good research papers on this issue. On the flip side, I'd take a statin for cholesterol in a heartbeat, something that is vilified on the web as a means of fueling garbage non-effective products for high cholesterol. That makes our job much harder when it comes to trying to educate patients. As comments are a bit slow, I'll add mine. As a psychiatrist, olanzapine. It works, but at a cost of diabetes, hypercholesterolemia and huge weight gain. Edit, as this is getting rather more traction than I expected, I'll add some context. Olanzapine, like many of the antipsychotics, is an extremely powerful drug that for the right person can be extremely beneficial. Not everyone gets the side effects and many can take olanzapine without major problems. My problems with olanzapine are overuse, putting on a bit of weight. If you have life-crippling psychosis is one thing, less so when the target problem is distress or a bit of insomnia B. Since olanzapine was released, other meds have come onto the market that are genuinely lower in life-limiting side effects. Olanzapine seems to me to prescribe too frequently compared to other equally powerful medications that don't have quite so many problems. If I was ever diagnosed with schizophrenia or bipolar, I would hope to be prescribed lurasidone / aripiprazole / acenapine / possibly even haloperidol before olanzapine. Amphotericin B. It's one of the most potent antifungal drugs that we have. Side effects from Wiki. Amphotericin B is well known for its severe and potentially lethal side effects. Very often, it causes a serious reaction soon after infusion, within 1 to 3 hours, consisting of high fever, shaking chills, hypertension, anorexia, nausea, vomiting, headache, dyspnea and tachypnea, drowsiness, and generalized weakness. The violent chills and fevers have been nicknamed shake and bake. It's also toxic for the kidneys, liver, and bone marrow. Orthopedic surgeon. I'm most terrified by opiates. I have seen them absolute consume people to the point where it seems their only purpose in life is the procurement and consumption of narcotics. This is to the detriment of their loved ones, friends, jobs, etc. They become desperate shells of their former selves. It is so heartbreaking. I had surgery about a year or so ago and was convinced by family to take a single Percocet prescribed to me for the post-op pain. I hope that is the last opiate I ever take. As an emergency psych clinician who works in community hospitals, I would have to say Clonopin. They are super addictive, and I have seen countless people become shells of their former self on it. Every 2 weeks, the same people come in, because they binged on their meds, and ran out, and they then have to lie and say they are suicidal, in order to get admitted, so they get meds and avoid withdrawal. Half their life spent in the hospital for Clonopin. My dad is a doctor. Refuses to take opiates or really any painkiller stronger than Advil. Also nothing but local anesthesia. I once woke up in the hospital with him fiddling with my morphine drip, because the dose they have you on is too high. No, daddy, that was exactly the right dose. Hence me waking up in excruciating pain, and yelling what the fuck are you doing? Because you're fiddling with it. This thread worries me, that people are going to need one of these drugs, and refuse because I read it on the internet. It'll be a clicklist blog post next week. 10 plus drugs, so dangerous doctors won't take them. Every drug has side effects, some worse than others. When deciding to take them, the risks and benefits have to be evaluated. Your doctor has training to help you decide. Don't rely on Google. I'm really late to the comments, but I had to get it out. Pharmacist here, Amy Arderon / Corderone. Almost every other patient will get phototoxic reactions resulting in grayish blue skin. I feel sorry every time someone comes with a prescription. Also, I see ciprofloxacin being mentioned a lot. I see it widely prescribed for UT, and never heard of the tendonitis side effect from any patient. Took it myself as well, and never had any problems. I need to look into it a bit more. One night working in OR, I accidentally poked myself with a needle while I was suturing this guy's wound. We didn't know his HIV status. So as a part of post-exposure prophylaxis, I had to take an antiretroviral drug called zidovudine. One of the side effects of zidovudine is dizziness. And working on a busy night and feeling dizzy was one of the worst experiences I have ever had. We took his blood sample and sent it to test for HIV. Thankfully he was HIV negative. Or else I would have had to take the same drug plus another drug, called lamivudine, for a month, and live in paranoia for the rest of my life. Even though there are plenty of reasons to not wish for taking anti-HIV medications, including HIV itself and a lot of other, more horrible side effects, that experience made me not want to take zidovudine even more. Opiates. I think Chris from Stephen King's The Body said it best: what chance of putting it down do you think I would have if I ever picked it up? He was referring to alcohol, because his dad and brother were alcoholics. My father was an addict, my mother was an addict, my stepfather was an addict, my brother was an addict. What chance would I have? Erdoc here. I can't think of a single drug in any specialty I wouldn't take given the right circumstances. And we see them all in OR, from the weirdest drugs to the most common. There are times I go back, quote, why is this person possibly on this, but that's more misprescribing. Everything comes down to risk benefit. If I started taking a blood thinner today, it would be a bad idea, because my risk of bleeding is way higher than a thrombotic event. At 65 and with a fib. Jim. Zaloft. Oh man, the heartburn. I was on it for a year before a med switch, and I would get such intense heartburn that nothing, I mean nothing, worked. I would double over in pain from it, and dry heave and stomach acid would come out without any need of throwing up. I went begging to my doctor for something different. I was terrified to eat or drink anything, as it would intensify. Med switch, heartburn gone. Brother is a GI doc, and said never use switch Hazel products for hemorrhoids. Which Hazel is an astringent that will temporarily stop bleeding, but it dries out and damages the surrounding tissue, making the issue even worse in the longer run. Opioids. They completely mess up your stomach and your mind. The number of decent and good people who are basically begging for it every day breaks my heart. And they don't understand why they are constantly tired and have stomach pains, nausea, and problems with bowel movements. Fuck pharma. Pharmacist, and surgery. There is a specific instance where almost every drug is appropriate and there is none that I would say no to on the top of my head. There are instances of preferential drugs, but there are instances where a physician knows more than the patient, and the less preferred drug for the patient may actually be the most appropriate. Pharmacist here. Would really like to avoid warfarin if I could. It's a blood thinner that interacts with just about everything, making you more likely to bleed or more likely to clot depending on the interaction. Also, the first couple months or so require weekly INR checks through finger sticking, then after that it's every month. Not a doctor, but a technologist. Fucking Ambien. Despite being out like a light, you're likely still getting shit sleep, with the added bonus of being way the fuck more likely to sleepwalk and do weird shit in general whilst asleep. The first time I ever saw a sleep behavior disorder, it was made much much worse by Ambien. On a related note, having a patient drop their pants and masturbate vigorously in the middle of a running study is not a good way to spend an overpass shift. Neuroradiologist. No serious concerns, though I would feel a bit uneasy about repeated use of gadolinium contrast agent over the length of a few years or more. It was shown to accumulate in the brain, though so far, clinical side effects are yet unknown. Still, the thought of having some, very detectable, traces of a heavy rare earth in my brain isn't that comforting. Edit, because some of you seem to be concerned about this. Anybody requiring regular contrast MRI scans usually has a very good reason for that. Based on current knowledge about this finding, I would not advise any patient to refrain from gadolinium, and if I were in that position I wouldn't hesitate. However, radiologists should favor those versions of the drug we know to show less deposition, just to be extra safe, and I don't think any radiologist doesn't know about this. Not a doctor, but I take Ritalin UNO2X 40 mg a day for ADHD. If you get hit by the side effects, some of them can be increased pulse, increased blood pressure, cramps and spasms in legs, suicidal thoughts. That isn't bad compared to other types of medicine to combat mental illness. It's that people try to steal and or buy it from you. It's a drug for other people, they want to get high. Once some person stole 80% of my medicine from my backpack. $80 worth of medicine gone.